basically... got myself another group for Halls of Lightning Heroic Plus, which is the thing that I did the other day. Our tank is super well geared, which is kind of what I require when I am not super well geared myself. I'm geared okay. Halls of Lightning Heroic Plus is one of the easier ones from what I've heard. But it does take a little bit. Just everything has a ton of HP in Heroic Plus. I want to play, I'm assuming that's Ulduar, but there is no team. I need to get into a new guild, honestly. The other one wasn't doing anything. Even though they had stuff up in Discord for, like, joining raids, they basically never really did anything. Hopefully I'll get some more loot from Halls of Lightning Heroic Plus. I'm not entirely sure how Heroic Plus works exactly so far. I think it's just that they have a higher chance, or they drop like a second purple along with one of their blues. At least that's what it seems like. Yeah, we have a mage, so I don't even have to worry about using my own food aside from the buff food. Let me get my crit. I'm not sure why it hasn't marked the tank as the tank. My add-on is supposed to do that. I just want to make sure I add 80. Because 80 is how many mana strudels you can carry. I might as well just have the maximum amount. There it goes. Now it says he's a tank. I'm really not supposed to be doing damage for the most part, because I don't have a very high mana regen. But I think, yeah, we have a Shadow Priest, so they should be. WoW has a lot of class-specific things. So the Shadow Priest casting spells gives everybody in the party like a 1% mana regen every 5 seconds. I am grounded. I'm not supposed to move because I got lightning on me. If I move, I take damage. That's what that lightning is. Why? What? The Shadow Priest seems to have some add-on that announces things, but I do not speak. I don't read whatever language that's in. The hunter is just eating in the middle of the hall. Yeah, I believe he loses that when he reaches this point. You standing a little bit too close because he didn't lose his buff. He has adds that are healing him, which means that the adds need to die, and I'm not so sure that people are killing the adds. The Shadow Priest just take damage. Does he have a ranged attack that I forget about? I guess he does.
How can it be?
the exact same thing that he dropped the last time. Oh fuck, I used my own food, didn't I? I took a honey mint tea instead of my free mana strudel. In here, I think in normal heroic mode these things have 60,000 HP. They've got 3 times more HP than normal heroic mode. I don't really know how much more damage they deal. It's probably a fairly proportionate amount to their HP increase. Assuming one of the DPS is just annoyed that he keeps getting knocked around, which he can solve by standing in a corner. Is like the part I hate the most about this dungeon is what we're about to do. So these don't really deal any damage normally, but when they die, they explode. Sorry, are they immune to lightning? Oh god! That's why I don't like how groups are just like, I'm gonna AoE those down. It's like, oh yeah, kill everybody within range. But our entire group is ranged aside from the tank. The other day when I came in here, that was fucking terrible, because I think we had 2 melee along with the tank, and then 1 ranged. And, everybody exploded except for the tank and me. seriously, what is this? What do you have an add-on announcing? Oh god, why would you turn them this way? They have an AoE, my friend. So it has a knockback, and if they knock you down the stairs, then you take fall damage. So, turning them this way was not a good thing. Don't face them towards the stairs, please. Why is everyone still standing in the stairs? Stop letting them knock you downstairs. That's just stupid. They're just letting them toss them down the stairs. I don't understand your guys' logic. Please stop. Falling downstairs isn't good for your health. That mage is making some very questionable decisions. He's walking up the arcane explosion. I don't know that that's effective against three targets. The tank is dealing the most damage, so I'm going to say no. I don't need you to do much, but I need the tank to have the adds. It's just keep consecration down so that you've got the AoE. The longer you make this combat, the more adds he's gonna have. The harder it's going to be. The healer that gets the most out of things attacking me. Oh, I don't want to be there where he does that. Yeah, don't stand directly under the boss when he's shattering stuff. Sure, he's just dropping the exact same stuff he dropped yesterday. To get feared of pulling more of them by walking past a certain threshold. Tremor Totem didn't seem to stop them from getting more feared. This is very odd. It's fine for me. And one other person, I believe. Oh, God! Thank you. bad. I don't know what's standard for glyphs anymore on Shaman, but I'm glyphed to basically keep Earth Shield up. My glyphs currently are increase the length of my Riptide heal over time by 6 seconds, Earth Shield healing by 20%, and Lesser Healing Wave healing by 20% while my target is affected by Earth Shield. I would assume is fairly standard. Rating, you might have Chain Heal, the glyph of Chain Heal, because it gives you an extra target. The extra target only gets healed by like 10% of the amount your Chain Heal heals for, because of how Chain Heal works. It heals the first person for 100%, then the next person for 60%, the next person for... or the next... Is it 60-20? No. Yeah, 60, 20, and then the last person for 10% or something? That's weird. 100, 60, 20. So how does it even hit a fourth person? Is it 20 again? I must not have realized that his pet was getting attacked. Oh my god. You guys need to spread out. I don't like that you keep shooting that at me.
Run out.
Hunter's pet is just getting completely murdered.
Run out.
Probably the best group to have for this boss, because everybody's ranged. But everybody just needs to not stand directly next to each other. Same stuff from yesterday, I think. I don't think it's any better than attack power 116, haste 42. It's debatable. Also, I guess it dropped a green. Thank you. please don't run up there and pull yet. The vanguards will pull and we'll fucking die. Thank God he waited. Shadow Priest is AFK at the moment or something.
I'm out of range.
They keep targeting the hunter's pet. You just don't want that wolf to live. Oh god, is the wolf doing that to him? He was dying real fast. Leave me alone for 2 seconds. No, stop it. AFK for a little while. They didn't say anything, they just kind of left. I guess they did. You guys stood in the whirlwind. Thank you. also asleep. Okay, get some mana back. That was stressful. Oh god, it has been over a half hour, yeah. Heroic pluses take a while. What was all that? He put up his shield buff, or his blocking buff, before he even ran out. Okay, feigning death doesn't do anything there. You're gonna have to throw out your heal pet, man. I also need the tank to not line of sight me. You need another 3 minutes. You were just gone. Counterspell stops whirlwind? That seems weird. Although I guess wind shear stopping it too would be weird. The one that I was introduced to for stopping it was kick, which is the rogue's interrupt. You walked in the melee combat. No wonder you died. You are a mage. Please stop that. Almost entirely sure you gain nothing from being in melee combat unless there's like 10 of them. Just cast normal spells, please. Thank you. Is it not letting him accept the res? Or did he accidentally decline it? There we go. God, you guys are splitting DPS so fucking terribly, even though the tank is marking one. Seriously, sometimes they just completely fuck up his pet for like no goddamn reason. Yeah, the mage is making very questionable decisions about what skills he's using, as you can tell by the fact that our prot pally is dealing more damage than him. That shouldn't happen. Prot pallies, I think, are the lowest damaging tanks in the game, but they have one of the highest threat generations just because of how their tank stance works. Also, they have the highest AoE generation thanks to consecration. I can't cast that yet. Thank you. finally on to the last boss after nearly 50 minutes. I'm hoping this goes in just one one shot, because this
empires, the birth and extinction of entire species. Over countless millennia, the foolishness of mortals has remained the only constant. Your presence here confirms this. My master has shown me the future, and you have no place in it. Azeroth, what hope is there for you in dark? None! Your Shadon shall be released!
And so, he has a passive. Which deals damage the further away you are. That shouldn't have still hit me. And then he has Nova, which deals damage when you're too close to him.
You cannot hide from fate.
The fuck you guys for making this take so long. What dropped yesterday too. I mean, I'm not any of the classes that can use that apparently. That is not a me item either. Not a me item and tank. Still taking random fucking lightning damage. It's being Halls of Lightning Heroic Plus. I mean, I'm still not particularly well geared, but that one is apparently really easy on Heroic Plus for whatever reason. I think it's just because most of the mobs are fine to be tanked and spanked, whereas I had a group that invited me for iunno Rub Heroic Plus because they, when I put up, when I, because they have Heroic Plus out now, whenever I put up a group finder for Heroic, even though I put in my gear score and tell them, do not invite me for Heroic Plus, only normal Heroics, I do not have the gear for Heroic Plus, everyone invites me immediately for Heroic Plus because I'm a healer listed for Heroic. I'm like, if you do not whisper me, I will not fucking respond. But everyone invites me for Heroic Plus, and then when I got into Azul Narub, they completely fuck the party. Everybody gets poisoned. People get bound by that the web thing, and then everyone just fucking dies. And they're like, "Oh, it's impossible with this healer." And I'm like, "Well, I listed myself as do not invite for Heroic Plus." Honestly, Blizzard needs to make a separate create listing for Heroic Plus and not just have it under Heroic. But yeah, still trying to figure out exactly what I'm gonna do with WoW. It'll probably have to be a stream thing for the most part, but just go through some of the dungeons here and there,